The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
God's word is not just factual and true according to our knowledge. The word of Christ is truth itself, which sanctifies us and makes all things new in the life to come. And as we hear his word and believe in faith, let us open with prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your gracious word, which sustains us and gives us hope and life whenever we hear and are brought to faith by your Spirit. Help us to always hear and to believe. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us.
But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness.
Let us then confess our sins to God our Father. Most merciful God,
we confess that we are by nature sinful and unclean. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We justly deserve your present and eternal punishment. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen.
Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for you, and for his sake forgives you all your sins. As a called and ordained servant of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore forgive you all your sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord.
Cleanse our fears.
Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, you make the minds of your faithful to be of one will. Grant that we may love what you have commanded and desire what you promise. That among the many changes of this world, our hearts may be fixed where true joys are found. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. The first reading for the fifth Sunday of Easter is from Acts, the 11th chapter. Now the apostles and the brothers who were throughout Judea heard that the Gentiles also had received the word of God. So when Peter went up to Jerusalem, the circumcision party criticized him, saying, "You went to uncircumcised men and ate with them." But Peter began and explained it to them in order. "I was in this city of Joppa praying, and in a trance I saw a vision, something like a great sheet descending, being let down from heaven by its four corners, and it came down to me. Looking at it closely, I observed animals and beasts of prey and reptiles and birds of the air, and I heard a voice saying to me, 'Rise, Peter, kill and eat.' But I said, 'By no means, Lord, for nothing common or unclean has ever entered my mouth.' The voice answered a second time from heaven, 'What God has made clean, do not call common.' This happened three times, and all was drawn up again into heaven. And behold, at that very moment, three men arrived at the house in which we were, sent to me from Caesarea. And the Spirit told me to go with them, making no distinction. These six brothers also accompanied me, and we entered the man's house. And he told us how he had seen the angel stand in his house and say, 'Send to Joppa and bring Simon, who is called Peter. He will declare to you a message by which you will be saved, you and all your household.' And as I began to speak, the Holy Spirit fell on them just as on us at the beginning. And I remembered the word of the Lord, how he said, 'John baptized with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit.' If then God gave the same gift to them as he gave to us, when we believed in the Lord Jesus Christ, who was I that I could stand in God's way?" When they heard these things, they fell silent, and they glorified God, saying, "Then to the Gentiles also, God has granted repentance that leads to life." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Christians, to the Paschal victim, offer your thankful praises. O Lamb, O sheep has ransomed, Christ who only is sinless, reconciling sinners.
epistle lesson is from Revelation, the 21st chapter. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, the dwelling place of God is with man. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will be with them as their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and death shall be no more. Neither shall there be mourning, nor crying, nor pain any more, for the former things have passed away." And he who was seated on the throne said, "Behold, I am making all things new." Also he said, "Write this down, for these words are trustworthy and true." And he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give from the spring of the water of life without payment. The one who conquers will have this heritage. I will be his God, and he will be my son." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel according to St. John, the 16th chapter. Jesus said, "I still have many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. When the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into all the truth. For he will not speak on his own authority. Whatever he hears, he will speak, and he will declare to you the things that are to come. He will glorify me, for he will take what is mine and declare it to you. All that the Father has is mine. Therefore I said that he will take what is mine and declare it to you. A little while, and you will see me no longer, and again a little while, and you will see me." So some of his disciples said to one another, "What is this that he says to us? A little while, and you will not see me. And again, a little while, and you will see me. And because I'm going to the Father." So they were saying, "What does he mean by a little while?" We do not know what he is talking about. Jesus knew that they wanted to ask him, so he said to them, "Is this what you're asking yourselves? What I meant by saying, 'A little while, and you will not see me, and again a little while, and you'll see me'? Truly, truly, I say to you, you will weep and lament, but the world will rejoice. You will be sorrowful, but your sorrow will turn into joy. When a woman is giving birth, she has sorrow because her hour has come. But when she has delivered the baby, she no longer remembers the anguish, for joy that a human being has been born into the world. So also you have sorrow now, but I will see you again, and your hearts will rejoice, and no one will take your joy from you." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Thank you. my lips, and my mouth will declare your praise. Behold, the dwelling place of God is with man. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people. And God himself will be for them as their God. How do sinners stand before the holy God? Holy, righteous, without sin, perfect. Well, good works remove none of your sin. All of our righteous deeds have become like filthy rags in the sight of God. Your family line, your family tree, does not impress God. All who practice sin is a slave to sin. And your prayers cannot remove death and hell. It's only by faith. Faith in Jesus Christ. Do the sinners stand before the holy God in the blood of the Lamb? But the rebel, the old Adam, our old sinful nature, refuses to listen, refuses to repent. Ears are shut and hearts are hard. Unbelievers have a heart that is dedicated to worshiping idols, worshiping a god of our own making, thinking our words are better than God's word. And the wrath of God is being revealed from heaven against all ungodliness, against unrighteous men who in their unrighteousness suppress the truth. Old sinful ways, denying what is true, and the evidence of a sinful heart, the evidence of an unbeliever, is refusing to repent, deliberately continuing to sin, giving in to the old Adam, lust, hate, rebellion, adultery, homosexuality, transgenderism, lies, slander, gossip, revenge, and murder, as the scriptures teach. The faithless are detestable, murderers and sexually immoral, sorcerers and idolaters, liars. Their portion will be the lake that burns, sulfur, which is the second death. And it's from the heart that one is defiled. So it's high time we repent. We repent of our sin, and there's more joy in heaven over one sinner who repents. Good news. Jesus stands in the place of sinners. Jesus suffers the wrath of God for you because you have a great need of the trustworthy word of God, God's faithful promises fulfilled. Sinners stand before the holy God in the gospel, as the scriptures teach. Christ is the merciful and faithful high priest in service to God. He made payment for our sins. There is one God and one mediator between God and men, the man Christ Jesus, who gave himself as a ransom for you. It's the testimony given at the proper time. God has not abandoned you to wrath and a fiery grave. Rather, God has rescued you, redeemed you by his mercy. Sinners stand before the holy God in faith on Jesus Christ, his promises, his Good Friday hill. It is the noblest tree. God showed his love for you in this. While you're yet a sinner, Christ died for you. You've now been justified in the blood of Jesus. Romans 5. Sinners stand before the holy God, declared righteous. Trustworthy words. Jesus suspended between heaven and earth for you. The blood that is red runs with redemption to make you new. Divine justice in Jesus' hands and feet. Spear for his side that is riveted, a crown of thorns for his brow, and God's word for you. You're new. You're new by God's work for you. It's been signed in blood, forgiven. Jesus says, I am making all things new. Write this down. These words are trustworthy and true. It is done. It is finished. Christ is the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To make all things new does not mean that the church is about perpetual change. To make all things new means fulfillment. All that God has promised, Jesus has fulfilled for you, the sinner. You're new in forgiveness, You're new by faith. But do not let familiarity with these words turn to apathy. Push away the newness of life everlasting. New life. God for sinners. God for you. And the power of this comes to you by Jesus crucified and risen. It's a sure and certain word. And so Jesus breathes on the disciples, the Holy Spirit. And he says, if you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. Withhold forgiveness from any, it is withheld. Sinners stand before the Holy God new in forgiveness. Your sins are forgiven. The forgiveness that is preached, the forgiveness that is spoken one to another. The old is gone, the new has come. No more revenge, no more guilt, no more shame, no more living by the rules of the old Adam, reigning in sin. That's gone. The old has passed away, the new has come. And all of this is from God, through Christ who reconciled you to himself. He gave us the ministry of reconciliation. In Christ, God not counting your sins against you, he entrusted to us the message of reconciliation. We are ambassadors for Christ, God making his appeal through us. We implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. So the Lord declares, I make a new covenant. I make a new covenant with my people. Mercy and compassion, blessings and righteousness, peace in the fulfilled word of God. As the scriptures teach, God himself will be with them. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. Death shall be no more. Neither shall be there any mourning, nor crying, nor pain. For the former things have passed away. Like newborn infants, long for the pure spiritual milk, that by it you may grow up in salvation. Return once again to your baptism. And the baptismal waters are there for you every day to renew, to strengthen. Dead to sin, alive to God. Dead to pursuing idols, alive to serving thy neighbor, growing in faith, free, set free by God for good, good in the world, holy living, love and mercy. It's the fruit of the Spirit. By the power of God's word, God is at work in you, on you, and through you for good. As the scriptures teach, God justifies sinners by his grace, that we might become heirs according to hope of eternal life. This is a trustworthy saying. I want you to insist on these things so that those who believe in God may be careful to devote themselves to good works. These things are excellent and profitable for the people of God. The font of every blessing is God's word, and God's word is given to you that you would be a blessing one to another. New. Clean, righteous. I am making all things new. Write this down. These are the trustworthy, true words that God gives for you. Sinners stand before the Holy God new. Stand in faith. God will be your God, and we will be his people, forgiven. One of the portions of our liturgy we sing is Psalm 51. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation, and uphold me with a willing spirit. Return again, living by faith, renewed and strengthened, in Christ crucified and risen for you. You're new, and you're free. In the name of Jesus, amen. Rejoice our Lord's gifts, rejoice in his mercy. Our lips cannot remain silent. Rather, we confess God before the world. Today, we use the words of the Nicene Creed. Please stand. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God,
light of life, very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again, according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge both the living and the dead, whose kingdom will have no end. And I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets. And I believe in one holy Christian and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins. And I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. Heavenly Father, as we await for the last day and the resurrection of all the dead, calm our hearts and strengthen our faith to endure the trials you give us and to pick up our cross. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, grant your church your spirit, that she may always listen to the voice of Christ. Bless the word proclaimed throughout the world, and especially here at Zion. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, sanctify our homes, that your word may rule in them. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, bless our president, the governor, the Congress and legislature, judges and magistrates of our land. Guide them to serve according to your will and for the good of all. Raise up leaders with virtue and honesty who will defend the lives of all citizens. Protect those who defend us in the armed forces, even as you give peace to the nations. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, sustain those in sorrow, sickness, and tribulation, especially Barb, James, Betty, Dale, Larry, Dan, Carolyn, and Janelle. Comfort them by your holy word. Increase their faith and see them through their trials. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, prepare us to receive with faith and repentance your Son's body and blood and holy communion. It cleanses us from all sin. Unite us that we may believe and confess the one true faith. And bring us to that day when we shall be one people together at the heavenly banquet feast. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
all these things, and whatever else you know that we need, grant us, Father, for the sake of him who died and rose again, and now lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him
It is truly good, right, and salutary that we should at all times and in all places give thanks to you, Holy Lord, Almighty Father, everlasting God. And most especially are we bound to praise you on this day for the glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, the very Paschal Lamb, who was sacrificed for us and bore the sins of the world. By his dying, he has destroyed death, and by his rising again, he has restored to us everlasting life. Therefore, with Mary Magdalene, Peter, and John, and with all the witnesses of the resurrection, with angels and archangels, with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and saying, in your kingdom, and teach us to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power,
Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to the disciples, and said, Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me. In the same way also he took the cup after supper, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin
us pray. Gracious God, our Heavenly Father, you have given us a foretaste of the feast to come. In the Holy Supper of your Son's body and blood, keep us firm in the true faith throughout our days of pilgrimage, that on the day of his coming, we may, together with all your saints, celebrate the marriage feast of the Lamb in his kingdom, which has no end. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.
Thank you.